So this is like a spring, and it engages the both membrane and then pulling them together. And when it is pulling them together, what will happen? They will come together, and because this is a lipid membrane, what is this? Lipid membrane. And this membrane is also lipid? Bilayer. When lipid will come in touch with the lipid, lipid will fuse and virus will fuse. So GP41 molecule is a fusion molecule. What is it? Fusion molecule. Now question is that, what happened to Dr. Najib? He is putting so much time on those two molecules, because now many important clinical points are related with these two molecules. Let me tell you one thing. Number one, right now we are investigating on some drugs, right, which can block the CD4. If a drug can block CD4 successfully, if drug can block the CD4 molecule successfully, can virus enter into cell? No. But they are still working on these molecules because they are still working on these molecules because these molecules are very toxic, because they enter a block, many unwanted blockage on our normal cells, right? So this is under latest investigations and latest research going on in medical sciences, that we are looking for such kind of chemical molecules or drugs which can block CD4 molecule in such a way that 120 should not bind with that. Is that right? Okay. Number one. Number two, clinical point here. Number two clinical point here. I told you that when this virus enters in our body, most of the time, now listen very carefully, most of the time when this virus is acquired naturally, most of the time when this virus is acquired naturally, usually it interact with the help of, yes, help of CCR5, not with the CXCR4. What does that mean? Again, I will repeat it. It's worth repeating. That means once this cell, what is this? Once this, you are recording the lecture? You are not supposed to. Okay, no problem. Okay, so what I'm saying, that we are recording it for you, don't worry. Okay, so what we are doing, I'm talking about that once virus is naturally acquired, right? This virus will have two options. Either it bind with macrophages with co-receptor of CCR5, or it bind with T helper cell with CXCR4. Am I right? But most of the time, when virus first time enter in our body, they are capable of binding with CCR5. But once virus enter in our body, then after many generations of the virus develop the capability to interact with CXCR4. That is why in most of the naturally acquired cases of virus initially infect macrophages, not T helper cell. Is that right? This is one clinical point. And so again, I will say it in a simple way, that virus, when first time enters in your body, first what it is doing? It is infecting macrophages or dendritic cells, or those, or we can say initially most of the virus which is acquired, right, by natural means, this has tropism for CCR5. Tropism means attraction. But once virus multiply in our body, gradually new strains of virus appear due to changes in GP120, and then virus become predominantly able to interact with CXCR4, and that is the time when it becomes more dangerous for T helper cell. This is one important thing. Then I will tell you another important thing. They found, previously we thought that once this virus enter into a person, it will always produce AIDS if person lives long enough. For example, if I get HIV virus today, I don't want to tell how I get, but anyway, if I get, and tomorrow I die due to some accident, of course I will not get the AIDS. Because getting the virus and eventually developing severe immunosuppression and opportunistic infections and secondary neoplasia and neurological dysfunction, which is AIDS defining situations, right? That takes many years. On average, 7 to 8 years it is taken that once virus enter and eventually AIDS appear. Is that right? So it was considered previously that when HIV virus enters into human body, if person survive long enough, definitely that person will get which disease? AIDS. But they were surprised. They were some lucky people. They keep on having the virus for long, long, long time, and even they are not treated, they don't get any treatment, but still they don't get AIDS. They were surprised what's happening there. Some people do have virus in their body, especially this thing was seen about 1% of the population in what people? Not Africans, they are not so lucky in this matter. Northern Europe, European descendants, white people, right? That they were having the virus, but they were not getting the AIDS. So doctors were very surprised, we should find what is very special in these people, right? And they came to know. You know what was there? These people have mutations in the genes related with CCR5. You understand it? These people had mutations in what? Genes related with CCR5. Of course, these people will have two genes, one from mother, one from father. Those people who have maternal gene and paternal gene, both are defective and they are not properly expressing CCR5. Can virus really infect? No, these were the people who have natural immunity against HIV. So this is another clinical point related with this interaction, this deadly interaction, right? So 1% of Northern European population and their descendant white people, they are homozygous for the mutation in CCR5, and they are not develop, after getting HIV positive, they don't develop AIDS. Am I clear? Then about 10 to 15% of Northern European white descendants, 10 to 15% of people, they are heterozygous in this mutation of CCR5. It means that half of the CCR5 are normal and half of them are defective. So half of them which are normal interact with the GP120, but half of the molecule do not. So in these people, do you think virus will be able to invade very rapidly or very slowly? Very slowly. Are you understanding? You couldn't get it. I will explain it again. Listen, if you are very lucky, you will never get this virus. But anyway, if you are less than very lucky, you get this virus, but still you are very lucky and you have mutant CCR5s. Right? Maternal and paternal both genes, heterozygous. So you don't entertain the virus to enter. Do you think you will get this disease? You will have the HIV, but this HIV will not multiply very rapidly because it will not enter into cell and it will not destroy the immune system and you will not develop the AIDS. You got it clear? You are very fortunate. Then there may be another person who is relatively less fortunate. They are about cases like you are 1%. But 10% people, 15% people from Northern Europe descendants, they are having heterozygous mutations. It means maternal or paternal gene is defective. If one parent gene is defective, other parent gene is normal, they will express half CCR5s, normal, half defective. So virus has a chance to bind with the half co-receptors and not bind with half co-receptors. So virus will be very efficiently entering or poorly entering. So it will be progressing to the AIDS disease slowly or fastly?
Slowly.
Now you got it. This is another clinical point, right? And doctors are now looking for drugs. Okay, let's imagine if we make a drug, if a pharmaceutical company makes a drug and that drug is given to the patient and that drug bind with, what is this? CCR5. This is the drug molecule. It bind with CCR5. And now look at this poor virus. It is trying to find where is the CCR5, but the drug is between CCR5 and the GP120. You are understanding? Right? Now, do you think this can bind with that? No. So do you think virus will be able to enter? No. So will it be a good drug or bad? Good drug. Very good drug. Right? This is one strategy. Pharmacologically, you can fool this HIV virus that you develop a drug which can bind with which molecule? CCR5, and modify this molecule so much that GP120 cannot interact, right? The good news is this drug is available in the market. This is available now. What is the name of this drug? Who will tell me?
It is just like putting a rock here. You know, there's a girl, very beautiful, and the hand comes, but she's putting at important places some rocks, and hands cannot do anything. It's a frustrating situation, right? So this is rock-like molecule. What is the name of this drug? No one knows. Its name is Miraviroc. Its name is Mara, M-A-R-A, Miraviroc. So Miraviroc, this is another important point. Why I'm trying to hammer this molecule in your mind, that it has many clinical importance. If these molecules are absent, no interaction, no dangerous thing. If you find the girl, that she is not girl, no interaction. Right? Number two, half girl, little action. Or she's having some rocks here, again, only frustration. Is that right? So you understand it. So these are some important points related with CCR5 molecule and GP120. Am I clear up to this? Now, about GP120, I want to talk one more thing. Do you think up to now, there is a very intense research going on and work going on to develop a vaccine for HIV? Do you think we are really successful or not yet? Are we really very successful in making a vaccination? No, because if we have made vaccination, all of you will be happy. But you don't look happy, right? Because everyone is at risk for one or the other reason. Is that right? Now the question is that against many viruses, we have vaccination. We make vaccines. Why against this virus we cannot make vaccination? Anyone who can tell me? Why we are repeatedly failing in developing an effective vaccination against HIV virus? Anyone? Genetic variation in what? Very good. He's saying there's some genetic variation in the GP120. You can say he's very right. Actually, let me tell you. This GP120 is the real nasty thing. Number one, it helps it to attach. And number two, it keep on changing its faces. It's like a playboy boy. Right? Sometimes very good, sometimes very bad, sometimes attractive, sometimes depending upon the girl. Right? So this molecule knows how to change its face. Of course, this is a protein molecule, isn't it? It's a amino acid sequence. And amino acid sequence is determined by the gene's nucleotide sequence. Actually, the gene, the virus has a gene to make 120. Is that right? The gene which make 120, it rapidly undergoes mutations, alterations. When this gene, which make 120 molecule, this gene undergoes changes, then this molecule also undergoes changes. And if this molecule keep on undergoing changes, it becomes difficult for our antibodies to recognize it. Let me tell you how. Let's suppose, this is a very important point, that how GP120 keep on changing, right? Keep on changing its amino acid sequence and frustrating our efforts to make vaccination. Let me tell you exactly what happened. Now I'm going to make GP120 here, right? Let's suppose this is one hand, this is for CCR. Suppose this is for CXCR4. If it is activated, this is for what? CCR5. But there is another point here, and this point is here. This is called hypervariable region here. This hypervariable region, it becomes mutant, right? And in the same person, some 120 molecule, let's suppose, this virus enters into your body, and this point is like a star, right? Now you will make antibody against it. Let's suppose your immune system is activated and successfully make antibody against it. Now, antibodies are very specific with antigenic structure. Is that right? Let's suppose this virus has entered into my body, and against this point of GP120, I made an antibody. If this antibody bind with this point, can now this interact with CD4? No. So can virus infect other cells? No. Let's suppose I have one macrophage. Out of that macrophage, many virus come out. and virus have this antigenic structure at GP120, and I have made specific antibodies against this point. Antibodies will bind here, and now virus cannot bind with the other cells in the body. Is that right? And if virus cannot bind with the other cells in the body, can it infect? And when antibody binds with the viral structure and virus loses the ability to infect the cell, we say antibody has neutralized the virus. What we say? Antibody has neutralized the virus. So in immunological term, we say that such HIV antibodies which are anti-GP120, antibodies which are anti-GP120, these are neutralizing antibodies. Is that right? Now, the only problem is there that after little time, this virus will come and star is not there. Now there's a flower here. Now, because it has gone under antigenic variation, and our antibody was anti-star. Now, do you think this antibody will work here? No. And now virus will happily multiply, right, and fool our system. Is that right? Then, after some time, maybe we make another antibody which is anti-flower against this point. No problem. This virus after some time will again appear with another GP. Now it is laughing really too much. With what? GP120, which is having a moon here. Now these two antibodies will fail. This is the problem. Why virus make? This is one problem. It has many other ways to humiliate our immune system and eventually destroy. But one of the things is that GP120 molecule, it has many antigenic variants, right? And we keep on making antibodies against one variant, other variant appear, then other variant appear. And eventually, some variant appear against which we cannot make antibody, and that is really going to what?
Destroy
the whole system. Is that right? This is one thing. Second problem. This is how it plays, one of the way how it plays havoc with our immune system. Other is that when we think of developing vaccination, if you want to develop a vaccination against the HIV virus, you have to have make in the person body such antibodies which are neutralizing. Is that right? For example, there's a boy of 12-year-old, and we know soon he will start actions, and we want to vaccinate him against HIV. Which protein we will inject to him? GP120. Because if antibody is against the GP120, only then it will not attach, and he may get the virus, but virus will not be able to attach and enter and produce problem. So neutralizing antibody. But what happened? The problem is this. There are so many variants of what? GP120, that we cannot make a successful vaccination. For example, we make a vaccination with 20 type of and 20 different antigenic variant of GP120. But person get 21st or 23rd or I don't know what. So this is a very big problem, that this virus GP120 keep on changing its face, and antibodies against specific antigenic determinant, right? And due to this alteration, vaccination efforts are up to now not very successful. Right? So let me tell you what we have learned about this molecule. Number one, GP120 is the docking protein which is expressed on the outer side of the envelope. Number two, GP120 is associated with GP41. Number three, GP120 primarily binds with which molecule? CD4. Right? And with that, they will love to bind with a co-receptor. Right? The co-receptor, they can bind with CCR5 with macrophage or CXCR4 with T helper cells. And here we have a clinical point. There is a drug which is Maraviroc, which binds which receptor? CCR5. So it helps prevents the further entry of the virus. Then another point. If someone has homozygous mutations, right, in CCR5, right, they may have virus, but they cannot get the AIDS because virus cannot enter effectively and produce the disease. And if someone is heterozygous, they will be slow progressor. Am I clear? Yes, Any problem up to this? Another important point we learned, that why vaccination fail against, because neutralizing antibodies against the HIV viruses actually anti-GP120. But these neutralizing antibodies are not effective because this GP120 keep on altering its antigenic structure. Any question up to this? There is no. Yes, you have a question. GP120.
Even then it is able to attach itself to CD4 receptor. There must be something that remains unchanged.
Yeah, that's true. She has asked that if there are so many changes going on, then how is it still able to attach with that CD4 or attach with the, you can say, co-receptors? There must be something which is unchanged. Yes, this is true. Virus does not change everything. It only changes phase. There are many other things. Right? It does not change its hands. It does not change the point with which it binds with the CD4. But it changes phase from where it is recognized by our immune system. Very bad, isn't it? Very nasty. It is. Okay? So this is a specific point. If some virus alter here and then it cannot bind with CD4, it's a stupid virus. But virus is not stupid. All mankind is disturbed. Is that right? Am I clear? Any question more? Okay. So we have talked enough about GP120. Then we talked about GP41 and drug which bind with the... Yes. Now I told you the function of GP41. What was the special function of GP41? That once this is attached with primary receptor and secondary co-receptor, after that GP41 undergoes a change and help the membrane of virus envelope, help the virus envelope to fuse with the target cell membrane. So it is a right. And if we have a drug here, of course purpose of learning virology is not just remembering these molecules. The thing is that a good doctor should know why we remember them, why we understand them. Yes. If you make a drug again such a way that GP41, even if GP120 bind with CD4 and the chemokine receptor. But if a drug come here and this drug actually, let's suppose, disturb this drug bind over, what is this? GP41. If there is a drug which bind with GP41 and does not allow the GP41 to undergo activation, it's just like that. There's a boy, but his hands are tied and even legs are tied. Look at the frustration. We have a drug like that also. Right? No way to fusion or penetration or whatever you call that. There's a drug. Now we are working very hard to beat this virus, you know. By nature, we are cruel. You see how many ways we find to kill this virus and tiny virus. We do have a drug which bind with GP41, and once GP41 is bound with that drug, it cannot open its molecule and bind with the target cell membrane. So if that drug is there, that drug will be called which inhibitor? Yes? Fusion inhibitor. Very good. Previous drug was binding with CCR5. That was an attachment inhibitor. Now attachment is allowed, but fusion is not allowed. Ultimate frustration. So what is this? What is the name of this drug? Anyone? Anyone, please? You have very anti-HIV attitude. Anyone knows what is the drug which is which can stabilize GP41, and whatever happened with this, right? It does not become active, and then of course virus will not fuse with the target cell membrane and virus will not be able to infect the cell. What is the name of this drug? No one knows. Okay, let me tell you. Its name is, this is a drug which bind with GP41 and